ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
హలో, గుడ్ మార్నింగ్, వెల్కమ్ బ్యాక్. టుడే వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ నేచర్ ఆఫ్ లైట్ అండ్ ఎలక్ట్రోమాగ్నెటిక్ రేడియేషన్, క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్ ఆఫ్ వేవ్స్ ఆర్ రేడియేషన్స్. So these are the topics which we are going to study today. First, starting with nature of light. So let us study a few theories which try to explain the nature of light. According to corpuscular theory, light has particle nature. So corpuscular theory says that light possesses particle. So light travels in the form of a particle. So light has particle nature. The particle nature was able to explain some properties of light, but not all the properties. So that was its drawback. Later, James Maxwell proposed that radiations like light possess wave nature. That means the light travels in the form of waves, not like particle, but it travels in the form of wave. The wave nature was able to explain some other properties of light, but not all the properties. Electromagnetic radiation. So light is nothing but an electromagnetic radiation. But what is electromagnetic radiation? Electromagnetic radiations can be generated or produced when an oscillating charged particle like electron is placed in magnetic field. So apply some magnetic field, say this is north pole and south pole, and place an oscillating charged particle in the magnetic field. Or otherwise, what you have to do is you have to apply electric field, right? Apply electric field, place a magnet in it, oscillating magnet. So in short, when a charged particle, oscillating charged particle is placed in magnetic field or a magnet in electric field, then the radiations that are produced, we call them as electromagnetic radiations. Electromagnetic radiations are generated or produced when an oscillating charged particle is placed in an electric field, magnetic field, or a magnet in electric field. So these radiations or waves, they are associated with both electric field as well as magnetic field. So they contain both fields, electric fields and magnetic fields, right, traveling in the form of waves. How they will travel? They travel perpendicular to each other. Suppose if I consider this axis and this axis, so these two, they are perpendicular to each other. Suppose if electric field travels like waves in this along this face or axis, the magnetic field travels in the form of waves in this axis. They are perpendicular to each other and perpendicular to the direction of the wave. So let me try to draw it. Let us consider x axis and y axis. They are perpendicular to each other. So this is one electric field. So it's like they are perpendicular to each other. So if I consider this as electric field, blue one, then this will be the magnetic field. So what I am trying to say is electromagnetic radiation, they consist of both electric field, magnetic field, which travel in the form of waves in a direction perpendicular to each other and perpendicular to the direction of wave. Perpendicular direction of wave. If I consider this is the direction of the wave, so here these two faces you can consider, right? So in this plane you can consider magnetic field, in this plane you can consider electric field. They are perpendicular to each other and perpendicular to the propagation of wave. So this is general definition of electromagnetic radiation. Light is also an electromagnetic radiation. So electromagnetic radiations, all electromagnetic radiations, right, they travel with same velocity equal to that of light. All electromagnetic radiation, they travel with same velocity equal to that of light because they don't require any medium. So these are the few points about electromagnetic radiation. So light is also an electromagnetic radiation. Just to understand, you can write. So what we have studied, nature of light, corpuscular theory says that light has particle nature but was able to explain some properties, not all the properties of light. James Maxwell proposed that it possesses wave nature, right? So light travels in the form of wave. So let us study the characteristics of waves. Now we are going to study the characteristics of waves. Characteristics of waves. The first one. So let us start with wave cycle. Let us call this as point A, let us call this as point B. As wave travels from point A to point B, as wave travels from point A to point B, it is said to have complete one cycle, or simply we call it as wave cycle. Wave cycle or simply cycle. As wave travels from point A in like this to point B, it is said to have complete one cycle. You can see this up, this AB line we call it as equilibrium position, equilibrium position. So it is oscillating along this equilibrium position. The higher displacement or this upper displacement considered to with respect to the equilibrium position, we call it as crest. And this lower position or depth we call it as
rough.
So what is one cycle? When a wave travels from point A to point B, it is said to have complete one cycle, or simply wave cycle. The upper portion we call it as crest, the lower portion we call it as trough, AB line we call it as equilibrium position. Wavelength. So wavelength is represented with this letter, pronounced as lambda. So how to define wavelength? It is the distance between two successive crests or consecutive crests or two successive troughs. Either you can take two successive crests or two successive troughs. Or you can also define like this: it is a distance between two points present in the same phase of a wave. So the best one is two successive crests or troughs. So I am taking the highest point here, let us call this one here highest point. These are two consecutive crests. The distance between two successive crests we call it as wavelength. Or you can also take troughs, you can extend it. Can take this distance also. So what is wavelength? It is a distance between two successive or consecutive crests or two successive troughs, denoted with letter lambda. This one pronounced as lambda. So this is nothing but distance. In which unit you express distance?
The wavelength is expressed in centimeters, meters, angstroms, nanometers, micrometers, even you can use picometers.
So these are the units in which you can express wavelength, nothing but distance. So let us see the conversion. We all know 1 meter equal to 100 centimeters. 1 meter equal to 100 centimeters. Then 1 centimeter equal to 0.01 meters. 1 centimeter equal to 0.01 meters. 1 angstrom unit equal to, so this is 10⁻¹ centimeter. 1 angstrom unit equal to 10⁻¹ centimeter. Now how to convert this into meters? So if you want to convert this 1 angstrom unit equal to 10⁻¹ centimeters, you can write it as 10⁻¹ into 1 centimeter. Now I want to convert into which units? Meters. 1 centimeter equal to how many meters? 1 centimeter equal to 10⁻². So this is nothing but 10⁻¹. Instead of 1 centimeter, I am writing it as 10⁻². So minus 8, minus 2, you have to add it. What I will get is 10⁻¹⁰. So 1 angstrom unit is equal to 10⁻¹⁰. Now next, 1 nanometer. Nano is nothing but 10⁻¹. 1 nanometer is 10⁻¹ meters. I want to convert into centimeters. So let us try to convert it into centimeters. nanometer equal to 10 power minus 9 meter. You can write it as 10 power minus 9 into 1 meter. I want to convert into which unit? Centimeters. So 1 meter equal to how many centimeters? 1 meter equal to 100 centimeters. So this is 10 power minus 9 into 10 power 2 centimeters. It becomes minus 9 plus 2, minus 7 centimeters. So 1 nanometer equal to 10 power minus 7 centimeters. Right. So here 1 nanometer equal to 10 power minus 7 centimeter, 1 angstrom unit equal to 10 power minus 8 centimeter. So what is the relation between them? So 1 angstrom unit equal to 10 power minus 8 centimeters, which is equal to 10 power minus 1 into 10 power minus 7 centimeters. Send this other side, it becomes, this is 1 by 10, you can write it as 1 by 10 send other side, 10 into 1, it becomes 10 angstrom units equal to 10 power minus 7 centimeters. So instead of 10 power minus 7 centimeters, what I can write? 10 angstrom units. So 1 nanometer equal to 10 angstrom units, then 1 angstrom unit will be equal to 1 by 10 nanometer, that is nothing but 0.1 nanometer. Right, next. Micrometer. 1 micron 10 power minus 6, so 10 power minus 6 meters. You can write it as 10 power minus 6 into 1 meter. 1 meter equal to how many centimeters? 100. So 10 power minus 6 into 100 is 10 power minus 4 centimeters. Picometer. 1 picometer is 10 power minus 12 meters. 1 picometer is 10 power minus 12 meters. Convert into centimeters. 10 power minus 12 into 1 meter. 1 meter is nothing but 100 centimeters. So 10 power minus 12 into 100 is nothing but 10 power minus 10 centimeters. So these are the units and their conversions for wavelength. Wavelength is defined as the distance between two successive crests. It is expressed in these many different units. Now let us go for the next one. Say okay, frequency. Mu. It is pronounced as mu or nu. What is frequency? Number of cycles a wave can complete in 1 second. Okay, second low. Any cycles complete cheyagalutadi anedi count cheyali. So number of cycles, so for reference we take some point. Number of cycles a wave can complete through a point in 1 second. This is for just reference, right? Oka second lo any cycles wave complete cheyagalutadi oka point dwara annade frequency, number of cycles. For example, say from point A to point B, oka second lo ee point dwara ikkada varaku vachindi anukundam. So ikkada manaki
any let us count the number of wavelengths, number of cycles, and this is one. ఇక్కడ నుండి ఇక్కడ వన్ సైకిల్, వన్ క్రెస్ట్, వన్ డ్రాప్, దిస్ ఈజ్ అనదర్ వన్ సెకండ్, దిస్ ఈజ్ అనదర్ వన్ థర్డ్.
సో ఇట్ కంప్లీట్స్ త్రీ సైకిల్స్ త్రూ ఏ పాయింట్ ఇన్ వన్ సెకండ్. సో త్రీ సైకిల్స్ పర్ సెకండ్. సో ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ ఈజ్ డిఫైన్డ్ యాజ్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ వేవ్స్ పాసింగ్ త్రూ ఏ పాయింట్ ఇన్ వన్ సెకండ్. సో వాట్ విల్ బి ద యూనిట్స్?
ఇట్ ఈస్ డినోటెడ్ విత్ లెటర్ దిస్ వన్ న్యూ. And units, frequency, units, number of cycles per second. So simply cycles per second, cycles per second, CPS, or you can also express in hertz, HZ, or simply second inverse. These are the units, cycles per second, CPS, hertz, HZ, second inverse. So 1 CPS cycles per second equal to 1 hertz equal to 1 second inverse.
That means one a wave can complete one wave cycle in second, or the number of waves passing through a point in 1 second is 1. Right, so this is about frequency. So let us take two waves for comparison purpose. Now, let us imagine these two waves are having same velocity. They are having same velocity. So, in the first case, this is the wavelength. In the second case, this is the wavelength. As you can see, if the wavelength is more, then its frequency will be less. Because if wavelength is more, the number of cycles that pass through a point per unit time will be less. If wavelength is less, number of cycles that can pass through a point per unit time will be more. So smaller the wavelength, higher the frequency. That means frequency is inversely proportional to lambda. Frequency is inversely proportional to lambda. Smaller the wavelength, higher the frequency. Higher the wavelength, smaller will be the frequency. Already we have studied one point. That all electromagnetic radiation travel with velocity equal to that of light. What is velocity? Distance covered by the wave per unit time. Distance traveled by the wave per unit time. All electromagnetic radiation travel with same velocity equal to that of light. Then what is the speed of the light or velocity of the light? Velocity is represented with letter C. So velocity of the light is approximately 3 into 8 meters per second distance per unit time, 3 into 10 power 10 centimeters per second. So here the proportionality constant is nothing but velocity of light. So frequency
into lambda must be equal to C, or nu equal to C by lambda.
So if velocity is expressed in meters per second,
meters second inverse, then lambda must be expressed in meters, then the units of frequency will be second inverse.
Meter meter will be cancelled, so second inverse. So we have covered wavelength, we have covered the frequency, we have covered velocity. So let us study about
wave number. Nu bar,
the number of wave cycles in unit distance 7 centimeter, the number of wave cycles present, or wavelengths, number of wavelengths in unit distance.
Okay, distance lo enni waves unnai,
so this is some 1 meter or 1 meter, right? In unit distance, the number of wavelengths, we call it as wave number. So if wavelengths are more, wave number will be less.
Nu bar is equal to reciprocal of wavelength.
Wave number is equal to reciprocal of wavelength. If wavelength is more, then number of cycles in unit distance will be less, like this. So here you have only one, say if this is 1 centimeter, you have this, if I consider this as 1 lambda, the number of wave cycles will be less, right? If I consider the distance is same, here the number of cycles are more. So more the wave lambda, less will be the wave number. So lambda general unit centimeters meters, so this is reciprocal, so its units will be centimeter inverse or meter inverse. So once again, wave number is equal to reciprocal of its wavelength, right? So here 1 by lambda can be replaced with nu bar. Nu equal to C by lambda, so C into 1 by lambda, 1 by lambda is nothing but nu bar, so C into nu bar. Frequency of wave, velocity of wave, wavelength of wave, velocity of wave, wave number of wave.
Amplitude of wave. So amplitude of a wave is defined as the height of the crest
or depth of a trough
the maximum distance from its equilibrium position we call as amplitude.
It is the height of the crest or depth of a trough. It is a nothing but maximum distance from this equilibrium position, that we call it as amplitude. It is the, it determines intensity of wave. So what is the meaning of intensity of light? All those things we'll study in the next classes, right? It determines the intensity of radiation. So amplitude determines the intensity of radiation. One more thing is time period.
What is time period? The time taken for completion of one wave cycle by the wave, we call it as time period. time period is reciprocal.
So these are the properties. What we have studied is wavelength, we have studied velocity, frequency, wave number, amplitude and time period. Quantum theory of radiation. This is proposed by Max Planck. According to him, a hot body emits energy discontinuously. Generally, according to classical theory, energy is emitted continuously. But according to Max Planck, energy emitted by a hot body emits radiation or energy discontinuously, but not continuously. So he said that energy emitted by a hot body is quantized, right? Quantized, the meaning of the quantized is, here according to classical science, any amount of energy can be emitted. It can be 1 calorie, 1.1, 1.111, 1.12, like that. Any amount of energy is possible or emitted. But according to quantum theory, discrete energy levels are possible. 1 calorie, next one will be 2 calories. So no energy is available between 1 calorie and 2 calorie. But according to classical science, any amount of energy is available between 1 calorie and 2 calorie. You can take any integer value. But according to Max Planck, energy is quantized, right? For example, say this is, okay, 1 calorie, 2 calories, 3 calories. So if a ball moves from this point to this point, from here to here, now here its energy is 3 calories. When it comes here, it becomes 2 calories, right? So here it says either it can have 3 calories or 2 calories. If it comes here, its energy will change to 1 calorie. So either it can a ball can have 3 calories of energy or 2 calories of energy or 1 calorie, not in between them, right? So this is called quantization of energy, right? The energy can be discrete, definite and discrete. It cannot be 3.1, it cannot be 3.5, it cannot be 3.6, like that. Or it cannot be 2.5, 2.2, 2.1, like that. Either it can have 3 calories of energy or 2 calories, not in between 3 and 2, not in between 2 and 1. This is called quantization of energy. So let us come back to this theory again. Max Planck proposed that a hot body emits energy in the form of, emits energy discontinuously, right? So here the energy is emitted in the form of small energy packets, these energy packets he calls them as quantas. Right. So the energy is absorbed or emitted in the form of small energy packets known as quantas. The energy associated with each quanta is found to be directly proportional to the frequency of the wave or radiation. So let us assume the energy of each quanta as E, it is found to be directly proportional to frequency of the radiation, right? So 2 points. First one, a hot body emits energy discontinuously in the form of small energy packets known as quanta. The energy associated with each quanta, that is E, is found to be directly proportional to frequency of this radiation. So frequency is represented with nu, energy of photon is represented with E, E is proportional to nu.
So remove the proportionality, we get a constant H. So where E is
energy of photon,
H is called as Planck's quantum, nu is frequency. But already we have studied that nu equal to C by lambda. Therefore, what I can write E is equal to H nu. In the place of nu, what I can write? H C by lambda.
Right. But
nu bar equal to 1 by lambda. Therefore, E is equal to H nu, H C by lambda, H C nu bar. Where E denotes energy of photon or quanta, H Planck's constant, its value is 6.625 into 10⁻²⁷ ergs second, or 6.625 into 10⁻³⁴ joules second.
So C is velocity of light.
Or radiation you can say.
Lambda, wavelength of radiation. Nu bar is wave number. So from this, H is constant, so energy is directly proportional to frequency. H and C both are constant, so it is inversely proportional to wavelength. H and C are constant, directly proportional to wave number. So energy frequency, they are directly proportional, energy wavelength, they are inversely proportional. So let us study different electromagnetic radiation, EMR.
Cosmic rays. Gamma rays, X-rays, ultraviolet rays, visible rays, UV visible, infrared rays, IR, infrared rays, microwaves, radio waves, heat waves.
So these are the different electromagnetic radiations. Cosmic rays, gamma rays, X-rays, UV, visible, IR, microwave and radio waves. So if I move from left to right, from here to that side, left to right, what happens?
Energy frequency of radiation decreases
and wavelength increases. Energy frequency decreases, wavelength increases. If I move from right to left,
from my right to left, right to left,
energy frequency
increases, wavelength decreases.
That means cosmic rays has high energy than gamma rays, than X-rays, than UV, than visible, than IR, than microwaves, than radio waves. So as you know, visible is nothing but with GR. violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. It also follows the same order. Energy increases in this from red to violet. Frequency also increases, but wavelength decreases. From violet to red, wavelength increases, energy frequency decreases, because energy is directly proportional to frequency, energy is inversely proportional to wavelength. So let us do one simple problem. Suppose you have a light radiation of wavelength 300 nanometers. You have a light radiation of wavelength 300 nanometers. So wavelength is given. You are asked to find, say, frequency. Let us start with frequency. So nu equal to c by lambda. To find frequency, you have to know the value of c as well as lambda. We know that velocity of light is constant, right? So this is in nanometers. Let us convert into centimeters or meters. 300 into 1 nanometer. What is 1 nanometer equal to how many meters? 1 nanometer is 10 power minus 9 meters, right? So this is equal to what? 3 into 10 power 7 meters. So let us substitute here. Velocity of light is 3 into 10 power 8 meters per second. Then I have to substitute wavelength in which units? Meters. So then only the meters will be cancelled. So this is 3 into 10 power 8 meters per second. What is the wavelength in meters? Wavelength in meters is nothing but 3 into 10 power minus 7 meters. So 3 into 10 power minus 7 meters. Now again cancel. Meters. Again cancel 3. So left over is, if 10 power minus 1 goes to the numerator, it becomes 1 into 10 power 15 second inverse. So there is a frequency. We can also calculate wave number. Can also calculate energy. Let us see calculation of energy. Suppose if we are asked to find the energy of photon, quanta associated that wavelength. So what is the equation? E is equal to hc by lambda, or you can use h nu also. So h, Planck's constant, 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 joules second. Velocity of light, 3 into 10 power 8 meters second inverse. So see, velocity of light is in meters, so lambda must be calculated in meters, SI units, joules second, meter second inverse. Therefore lambda must be expressed in meters, right? So what is the lambda in meters? Lambda in meters is 3 into 10 power minus 7 meters. So it is 3 into 10 power minus 7 meters. So let us see. Now see here. Meters will be cancelled. Second inverse will be cancelled. So the units will be in joules. So here I can cancel 3. Minus 34, left over is 10 power 7. If I take this to numerator, it becomes 10 power 7. Units will be in joules per photon. So this is 6.625 into 10 power 8 plus 7, 15. Minus 34, therefore it is minus 19 joules.